The autopilot or flight control system that we show here is a device that is used to control all kinds of unmanned vehicles. So from rotary wing to fixed wing or hybrid designs, this is the device that is kind of the brain of the system and that can control it. We have various variants of this system, from big drones like the Male Hale class down to smaller ones like the 5-ton class of UAVs that, for example, we see here just above me, which we use to catch other drones. We are very proud to say that the MF7 Autopilot is the smallest, most lightweight, ITAR-free and certified system that is currently available. So our MF7 Autopilot is an all-in-one solution for smaller drones. It's actually the brain inside the drone, and it handles everything from controlling the airplane to the data link and the video link. So with MF7 in your drone, you are really set, and we can integrate it in any kind of drone, be it a rotary wing one or a fixed wing one, or also the modern hybrid designs. I think we know that all of us see drones in many, many applications these days. One application or one scenario that is becoming more and more important is the collaboration between manned platforms on one hand and unmanned platforms on the other hand. So just imagine there is a big accident on the motorway. Today you have a helicopter operating there. It might be very useful to complement the helicopter with an additional UAV to look closer to certain aspects of the accident. And the autopilot that we are showing here is also capable of doing this collaboration between the manned and the unmanned platform. When we started to design our autopilots, we really wanted to follow a green sheet approach, both with regard to hardware and to software. So there is no legacy code in the system. This is very helpful as we are fully platform agnostic. We can integrate the autopilot in any current air vehicle. Automation is becoming more and more important for UAV operators. They have a mission to fulfill, and this is key, not just to control or to fly the airplane. We are supporting this approach with a very, very high degree of automation. We can auto-taxi, auto-takeoff, fly along a pre-programmed course with waypoints in three-dimensional space. We can return to the base, we can land automatically, and even if the data link should fail, we have a return to home function that allows the drone to come back and land safely. Augmented reality and machine learning are definitely the next level. Just imagine a counter UAV scenario where our catcher drone will have to deploy a net to catch an incoming hostile drone. The drone will need a very high degree of automation and intelligence to do the intercept. And this is definitely the next level and the next step we are now integrating into our system.